Hello, my dear students. On your request, I am back with a lecture on a new topic from your syllabus, that is duration of pregnancy and factors affecting gestation length. As you might be knowing that a fixed gestation period is such a remarked feature of mammalian reproductive cycle that it must have been the subject of strong selection pressure during the course of evolution. Let me elaborate it that, as you know, every species have its own gestation length. We will understand how it is determined, how the gestation period or gestation length of a particular species is determined, what are those factors which can alter the gestation length or the determine particular length of intrauterine development of a particular organism. So, on your mark, let us start the topic duration of pregnancy and factors affecting gestation length. First of all, we have to understand the term gestation. What does it mean? Gestation and another analogous term, that is incubation. This incubation term is analogous to gestation in case of avian species. And in mammalian species, gestation can be defined as the time between conception and birth. And during this time, the embryo or fetus develops in the uterus. In other words, gestation is the period of intrauterine development of an organism that is termed as gestation. Or in simplest words, we can say the interval extending between fertile mating to parturition. Now, by this definition, to calculate the gestation length of any organism, we have to calculate the days of intrauterine development of that particular organism, and it starts right from the fertilization up to the birth or parturition of that organism. So, out of these two set points of the intrauterine development, that is the onset means fertilization and end of development, that is parturition. The parturition is easily identified and fertilization can't be recognized easily. So, in case of animals, we consider the fertile mating as the day of fertilization. But again, this definition becomes ambiguous in case of primates like human and monkeys, where the mating happens every day or frequently, even after the conception or even after the fertilization. And moreover, in case of primates, unlike animals, the fertile period is not remarkable. Just like in other mammals, oestrus is the most fertile period, and it is already defined that ovulation occurs during the ending phase of oestrus. But in case of primates, human and monkeys, this ovulation period is not well defined or cannot be easily recognized by the external symptoms. And hence, the exact time of conception becomes quite difficult to recognize. So, in these cases, the beginning of gestation is usually dated from some well-defined point in the reproductive cycle, and that is the beginning of previous menstrual period. Now, the whole gestation length is categorized in three major phases generally for all the species, and the first phase is period of ovum or blastula, or it is also defined as the period from fertilization to the next 12 days. Next phase is the period of embryo or period of organogenesis, and this period varies as per species. In case of cow, period from day 13 to day 45 post fertilization. In case of ewe, day 11 to day 34. In case of mare, it is the day 13 to day 55 after mating or fertilization. The last phase is period of fetus, and the remaining period after organogenesis means in cow from day 46 up to the calving. In case of ewe, day 35 to lambing, and in case of mare, it is the day 60 to falling. This period is termed as period of foetus. So in this slide you can see the gestation length of different domestic animals, which is given in physiological range as well as the average gestation length. And here you can see the gestation length of different species varies. Even within the same species, there is variable gestation length. For example, in case of canines, the gestation length varies from day 58 to day 66. So in further slides, we will see how these variations are controlled by different factors. And here the gestation length is given in increasing order, as you can see. In next slide, the gestation length in different wild animals or non-domesticated animals, you can see here. And again here in this table, I have highlighted two particular species. One is kangaroo and another is guinea pig. And why I have highlighted these particular species, we will understand in the further slide. So this slide is the summary of different factors influencing gestation length and are broadly classified into four categories, that is genetic factors, environmental factors, maternal factors and fetal factors. And again, these major categories are subdivided as per different variables. For example, genetic factors are again divided as per species, breed, fetal genotype and size of species. Likewise, environmental factors are again subdivided as per habitat, nutrition, season of conception and birth, and maternal factors are divided as per age of the dam, parity of dam, body weight of the dam, and the fetal factors are divided as per fetal maturity at birth, litter size, sex of fetus, and fetal size and weight. Let us start with the genetic factors. And under genetic factors, first is the species. As we have seen in previous slides, every species have its own gestation length. Means the length of gestation varies from species to species. And the next factor is breed. If we make the species constant, if we consider a single species and breed wise variations, if we see variation in gestation length also. And these breed wise variations are more marked in equine than bovine and ovine and porcine species. Let us take one example of bovine species, and bovine includes cattle and buffalo. And if you see the indigenous versus exotic cattle breeds, gestation length is longer in case of indigenous, that is Bos indicus, as compared to exotic cattle, that is Bos taurus. And again, if you classify beef versus dairy cattle breeds, gestation length is generally longer in case of beef cattle as compared to dairy cattle. And if you see the buffalo's various breeds, the gestation length is longest in Egyptian buffalo, then in Indian and Pakistani buffaloes, and lesser in Brazilian buffaloes. Again, you can categorize the buffaloes as swamp buffaloes versus riverine buffaloes, and the gestation length is longer in case of swamp buffaloes as compared to riverine buffaloes. And in this table you can see the breed wise variation in gestation length of some of the dairy breeds of cattle. And here you can see the gestation length starts from 278 days and it goes up to 295 days. There is huge variation among different breeds of the cattle. And here you can see the species is same, even though the breed wise variations exist. So under the same category, the third factor is influence of fetal genotype on gestation length. And the fetal genotype is the most important single determinant of gestation length. And it also plays an important role in determining the intraspecific differences in gestation length, as it accounts for breed differences, and other intraspecific variations such as those occurring between geographically isolated populations. Now let me explain it with the help of crossbreeds and hybrids. Let us take one example of crossbreeding between the Jersey and Gir cattle. So here we have taken the semen of Jersey cattle breed and we have inseminated with this semen to the Gir dam. Now as you know, the gestation length of both the breeds are different. In case of Jersey, the gestation length is 280 days, whereas in case of Gir cow, it is 292 days. So in this pregnancy, what should be the gestation length? Whether as per the dam, 292 days, or as per the sire, 280 days. Now in this pregnancy, the gestation length will be the average of both the breeds, and that will be near around 286 days. Take another example. Here we have taken a Jersey embryo and we have transferred this embryo into the Gir recipient cow, and again the question is the same, whether gestation length will be 292 days as per the recipient or as per the embryo, that is 280 days. Now here you might have noticed that this is somewhat different case than the earlier example. Here there is no crossbreed. Here the embryo is from the pure Jersey breed and there is no crossbreeding. So the gestation length should not be the average of both the pure breeds. And to your surprise, the gestation length is 280 days as per the breed of embryo, not as per the dam. And this was experimentally demonstrated by King et al. In 1985, who did the embryo transfer into the different breeds of cattle and found that calf breed is more influential than the recipient breed in determining the gestation length. Furthermore, strain-wise differences in mean gestation length has been noted within the same breed based on the percentage of Holstein Friesian versus Dutch Friesian genes. And if we talk about the hybrids, means crossing between two different species, although these species are always closely related species, and then crossing is possible. And here again, it was found that the hybrid is carried for a period lying somewhere between those of the two parents and somewhat inclined towards the mother's species. Means if we take an example of crossing between the mare and Jack, you know the gestation length of both the parents species are different. In case of equine, gestation length is around 337 days, whereas in case of donkeys it is 365 days. So as per rule, in this cross the pregnancy should last up to the average, that comes around 351 days. And here in this case the mule is carried up to 347 days. That means the average was 351 days and the actual gestation was 347 days. It means the gestation is slightly lesser than the average, means it is inclined towards the mother species, as the mother species is having lesser gestation period. And similarly, if you take the example of buffaloes, crossing in buffaloes two different strains, riverine versus swamp, you will find the gestation length in the hybrid is around 315 days. The last variable under genetic factors is the size of species, and the length of gestation period is largely a matter of size of species. As a thumb rule, smaller the animal species, shorter the gestation length. So it takes a longer time for a big animal such an elephant to grow a baby than for a smaller animal such as a mouse. As you can see, the smaller the animal like mouse, it is having the gestation period of around 20 days versus rabbit, that is quite larger in the size, body size, and the gestation period is also longer, that is 31 days. If you compare two different breeds of the same species like a rhesus monkey, the gestation period is around 164 days, and baboons, which are the another strains of the monkeys, and they are quite larger in the size than the rhesus monkey, and hence the gestation period is also quite longer, that is 187 days. Now the exceptions are also there, it is not a hard and fast rule. Here you can see the gestation period is given in the increasing order, that is 22 days, 31 days, 63 days and 68 days. But if you compare the size of different species, the guinea pig becomes an exception. Here the position of guinea pigs should not be at fourth position, it should be at the second position as per the size, but still as per the gestation length it comes at fourth number. It means the size of a species is not universally applicable in all of the animals or all of the species. So this is all about the genetic factors which controls or which determines the gestation length in different animal species. Now the next factor is environmental factors, and we will deal into the details of individual variables under environmental factors in the next lecture. This is all about today. Thank you. Thank you very much.